Assalamualaikum. Welcome back, children, for the social science class, 6th standard. And today we are going to have the second topic. It's being called Harappan Civilization. Okay, children? Shall we move on? Okay. In previous class, we have been learned about the first topic. It's being called the sources and about the archaeologists and everything. Now, let us move on to the Harappan Civilization, what it used to say. So, here, early man life. Early man life in previous where we have been seeing that he was being an up and down for the struggles and everything. Later he discovered so many things. He found he is a person to have about the fire for the purpose of cooking food, and he had numerous talents here where he used to have a nomadic life in search of food. He used to gather a lot of food. He never stayed in one place. Later, as he was just moving from one place to another place, he was being unsuccessful to have new discoveries. Later, he started to have a very good life here. New inventions he started, like taking care of the domestic animals, then afterwards cooking of food, and agriculture was the main occupation of the person. He started to cultivate different crops here. And later, of the early man here, he is a person to have a life of founding of many towns and cities and discovered many things here. And in this early man life here, when he discovered, he gave a new structure for systematic called as in agriculture, where he started cultivate the barley, wheat, rice, etc. Many more things here, and he gave an attention to human talents. He brought out his talents here, like weaving, pottery and carpentry. So this has been a main talent, hidden talent of a man here. And then comes barter system. What is this barter system? One thing is exchange for another. So now we have the barter system of exchanging good, and we get in return. For example, if we give rice to a nation, Bangladesh, and they give us cotton. So, or it may be whatever we require here. But in those days, exchanging one product, if the person has been giving barley, in return he may get some animals here. So that is being called barter system. That was common. And after barter system, we have to study about how it came to be known as Harappan civilization. A larger area, nodes of human habitations came to known as Indus Valley civilization or Harappan civilization. So man was completely in structure. He learned so many things here. He started to live a life near the river bank here. That's been to Indus. And in that, many people started to survive their life here. So it came to known as Indus Valley civilization. That is about 5000 years here go. And later in 1921, where we have the archaeologist, when they started to study about this Indus Valley civilization, and they came to know, yeah, the man was been living a life here in so and so way. It has been brought up a discovery in form of information, and so we have been reading in books here. You can see the picture in your page number 17, that you have the map and how the locations came. Okay, children, as I was saying about the archaeologist, who is this archaeologist? In early class also we have been studied, a person who is to have a discovery, new inventions. He used to study about a hidden thing that has been present inside the earth, and so he is being called as archaeologist. His only work is to have searching here, like it has been written on pillars, inscriptions and everything. So he used to give up information. So this is also brought up by archaeologist. The person to discover in 1921 a first Harappan is being called Dr. Sahani. Okay, children. So till here we have learned about the introduction. Now let us move the discovery and extent. How it discovered this Mohenjo-daro and Harappan civilization. Mohenjo-daro means the mound of the dead. So first the discoverer person they title separate. What is this Mohenjo-daro? Then later comes here for Harappan civilization here. Mohenjo-daro means the mound of the dead. It is also called this mound, meaning it used to say raised of mass earth, or you can say a small hilly area. So that is called a mound of the dead. Where it is situated? It is situated in a place called Larkana, district of Sindh, to the bank of the river Indus. Now, after this, let us move on. What are the other things that we can learn the fact of Mohenjo-Daro civilization here, where it can be seen in a place of Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, etc. Okay? Now, next comes geographical extent. What is this geographical extent? The geographical extent in the sense here, it is really found by the archaeologists where they have been seen and given an information about the baked bricks, very hard bricks. It has been given an information. Yes, this has been where the people were having a life here. So and so, this has been called Mohenjo-Daro, where they have a storied building. They have been busy in their agriculture, in different type of art and craft, and everything has been discovered. Geographical extent here, we can see in the place of West Punjab, Haryana, Jammu, etc. Many more places we can see. And next comes the growth and development of Harappan culture. How it started to have a cultivation, where it was being found. Harappan culture mainly found on mainly in the fertile crescent. Crescent is nothing but it's been a narrow curve shape, narrow, very tiny tapering. Means in between we can see this, the two rivers called River Tigris and River Euphrates. Now it is being called in modern Iraq, where we can see this culture that's being called the Mohenjo-Daro and Harappan to the River Tigris and River Euphrates in modern Iraq. Not only there, we can see in China also, that's being called Huangpu Valley of China. Then comes in Egypt, it is being called the River Nile. Egypt is very popular. It's being called one of the wonders of the world. For what purpose? Can you give me answer? Can you think why Egypt has been called one of the wonders of the world? Speciality? Yes, it has been called pyramids. Okay, so for that, not only for pyramids, and also it has been very popular where we have been hearing in our day-to-day stories, and the dead bodies wrapped in the coffin where they have been kept, they have been called mummies. Okay, that we can see. So we can find in three, that's been called modern Iraq, China and Egypt here. And now this Egypt, I was saying about the River Nile, the pyramids have been one of the wonders of the world here. Who was ruling? It's been called the King Pharaoh. Okay. Now, after having to this, now let us move on to the next call, the builders of civilization. Who built this one? Do we have seen that one? No. Only we have been studying in our book. It's been information given by who? Archaeologists, historians, okay. So they said that it has been built up by Dravidians, and Dravidians said Aryans. Aryans said built up by Sumerians. Still the historians don't know who is the actual person to discover the Mohenjo-Daro, where the seals have been written in language that's been in a place called Mohenjo-Daro. You can see the seals in page number 18, where the burnt bricks have been there, and you have many more pictures in page number 19 and 20. Okay, now let us come here, very beautiful, interesting town planning of Harappan and Mohenjo-Daro. How they were living Mohenjo-Daro and Harappan, the town planning, how they were living here. Now we have a spacious house. We can see different type of houses here. Living from hut to a very good spacious house built up by man here. Mohenjo-Daro has been very popular for the cities where the man was living a life here. What type of a well planned, very beautifully planning has been done by the people. They have been built up in similar way, a very good stylish building, and also the cities are very safe, and they have been stretching from this end that I'm showing from here. This has been in west, and that is to east, and from north to south, straight it is, and it has been of very neatness and very safety, and they have been found for the surroundings for hygiene and good hygiene and a very good protection. Who? The town planning made by Mohenjo-Daro. It is being called urban civilization. Urban means city, rural means village. Okay, they had a life in form of city life. Who? Mohenjo-daro people. And when I said about the stretching from west to east, not to south, they have been exactly right angle. Like this, I have drawn a line. Right angle is nothing but exact to 90 degree. And they have been having a very spacious houses in neat way and very strong building, bisecting here one building, here one building, and opposite to that, same in line ways they used to have their story building. And now after having to this, now let us come here to the next called citadel. What is this citadel? Citadel is nothing but Harappan civilization and Mohenjo-daro. These two, Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, are divided into two. One is called public buildings and granaries. What is this public buildings? Public buildings are man habitation where a common people used to have their life here. Granaries are nothing but storage. Now we say the godowns, right? In those time, granaries where they used to keep the stock of food or the made things for the purpose here. So they are called granaries. Citadel is nothing but Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. What they have been divided into two, public buildings and granaries. Now here, but this Mohenjo-daro was been in danger. It has been affected in natural disaster, then and then floods. So can we stop that one? No, it has been by naturally here, so the people has to shifted. That brought one very sadness to the people of Mohenjo-daro. And the granaries where the people have been working, what are the things they used to store and keep there? Copper, bronze, lead, they all used to manufacture and store there. And the people, those have been working, the granaries, the people, manufacturing people, workers, they used to stay in very small rooms here where they can come and start their business again to the next day. Okay children, inshallah to the next we will continue this topic. Thank you.